I belong to a cohort of female doctors, and majority of our medical workforce in Pakistan, almost 70% is female doctors. 50% of our population, almost 100 million people, do not get access to quality healthcare. It is not easy for people to perceive a female boss or a female leader. My name is Dr. Sara Saeed Khurram. I am born and brought up in Karachi. I've done my initial schooling from St. Joseph's. I've done my medical graduation from Dow. I've done my residency in radiology. I've done a master's in health policy and management from Aga Khan University. I'm married and I have two young daughters, 7 and 2 years old. So the company that I run in Pakistan is called Sehat Kahani, which means the story of health. And there were two main purposes to start this company. The first is I belong to a cohort of female doctors, and majority of our medical workforce in Pakistan, almost 70% is female doctors. But unfortunately, only 1 out of 3 of these doctors make to formal practice. So they leave their careers after graduation and before starting a formal practice in healthcare. When I started doing online consultations in a small community in Karachi, because I was based in Lahore and I used to do on-call and online consultations, later, through a discussion between the partners, we realized that why not we replicate the idea for all female doctors who can be placed in and outside Pakistan and connect them to patients in communities where healthcare is not accessible. I think I was always trained by my parents and society to be a clinician, to be a doctor, and I was a doctor bride. So once I started my own organization, the first challenge came of convincing the people around me that I can run a business, I can run an organization of my own. It is not easy for people to perceive a female boss or a female leader in the industry that we are and in the corporate industry. So it was challenging, but I think as time grew, as we expanded our work, as we met more people, as we developed our network, as we found a lot of supporters and mentors, the journey started becoming easier. But yet some of the challenges were due to us being female founders, not one but two female founders running the company. Again, through a cohort of network and finding the right people to invest, we overcame this challenge. I think whatever I am today, I am at 24 years old, I was a doctor. At 34 years old, a decade later, I'm a woman leader, I'm a CEO of a company. I make all my financial decisions independently without anyone's influence. And I think that has given me another perspective in life, that women don't value their mind and their ability to control finances and operations to the extent that men do. They always question themselves more. But once you get into the habit of doing it, once you do it on a daily basis as men do, you realize it's not that difficult. I think it just gives more security. I think women generally don't feel secure earnings in their own life until and unless someone else is giving security to them. Mostly, it is the opposite gender. It is the father of the house or the husband or the brother who's giving them security. But you can have a sense of security in yourself if you are financially independent. It's not just a pool of money that you've saved somewhere. It gives you confidence. वो तमाम खवातीन जो इस मुल्क के बेहतर मुस्तकबिल के लिए आज जिद्दोजहद कर रही हैं, मैं उन सब से कहना चाहती हूँ कि ये वतन तुम्हारा है।